Today, I'm going to show you how you can create a form field that will repeat in several places throughout your document. You may have a need to do this if you have your user fill out the name at the top of the form, and then you want to have that name filled in other places in the document. Be sure and check out the playlist on my channel for creating fillable forms. All right, let's get started. So in this form, we've created a document that has legacy tool form fields, and I have a plain text form field for the user to fill in their name at the top of the form. Then down here, I have two places where I want to have that name repeated in the document without the user having to fill in their name three times. So what I'm going to do, the first thing I'm going to do is label this form field. In order to do that, I'm going to come up to the form field and click on properties. And under the bookmark section, I'm going to label this name. And what I'm going to do is check the box that says calculate on exit and then click OK. Now what I want to do is come down here where I know I want to place that name as a reference in the document. So what I'll do is I'll come down here and delete the highlighted area, and I'm going to hit Control F9. Depending on your keyboard, you may need to hit Control Function F9. And what that does is it inserts a reference for you to reference back to that cell that you named, or that form field that you named name. So what we do is we insert those brackets, and then we're going to type REF for reference, and then put a space, and we're going to type exactly what we labeled that form field, and we labeled it name with a capital N. And that's all we have to do. And I'm going to come down here and do the same thing in this area where I want the reference to that same form field, the name. And I'm going to hit Control F9. And instead of name, we're going to type ref and the name of the form field. And then what we're going to do is go up to our restrict editing section, and we are going to check box number 2 and select from the drop down filling in forms, and then say yes, start enforcing protection. And we're not going to put a password, we'll just click OK. Now notice what happened was those areas where you had a reference seemed to disappear. So what we want to do is, as a user now, we would come up and fill in our name here, and we would tab to the next field, and notice that those two areas where we put in a reference to that form field now contain the data that the user entered in those form fields. So it's an easy way that you can make your forms simpler and quicker for your users to fill out by referencing back to a form field that you labeled. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and leave comments in the section below if you have any questions, and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.